Now, my next guest is one of the busiest people in the wacky world of showbiz, from hosting his Radio 2 show at the weekends to keeping us up to date with all the backstage news on Strictly's It Takes Two. And now Rylan is hosting a new podcast where he reunites. I like that, Rylan.
Thanks.
Some of our favourite stars. Well, Rylan joins me now. What a cracking idea for a podcast.
Do you know what? It's been
such
lovely.
A good idea.
First of all, it was happy birthday, by the way.
Thank you.
Lovely to see you. it was something that we did in lockdown about a year and a half ago. And we did like a Big Brother reunion over Zoom.
That's
because obviously, you know how much I love Big Brother.
Of course.
And then we did that one and everyone loved it. So we said, all right, I'll do an X Factor one from my year when I was on it.
Right.
So we all got back together. It was so nice speaking to everyone. And then obviously I was working with Sky Bingo at the time. And they were like, why don't we do it for real?
Yeah.
And I went, I mean, if you want. And I was like, I don't know if I can fit it in, but I'll try. And it's just been so lovely. Like, we've had some brilliant guests. Obviously, you saw the one there with Vernon. Oh. So we have a guest on, and it's someone I've either met or I've admired growing up.
Right.
And we reunite them with someone from their past. So we had Vernon, had, like, Beverly on there. We also got June Sarpong on that one as well, from T4 Days, which was amazing. Them two together, even now, just terrible. I don't know what's made the edit. I really, really don't. but we had Mara Wilson, Matilda.
Yes.
Actual Matilda.
Yes. She's great.
What an icon. And she was so open and honest as well.
That's the thing about podcasts, though.
Yeah.
People are really... I don't mean... When I say disarmed, I mean it in a good way.
No, but they are.
They will talk about it.
Yeah.
And you've got to get a device, haven't you, in order to talk to people. And that one is so good because you'll get to hear stories that you probably wouldn't.
No. And some of the stories that she was saying about being on that set sort of with, like, Danny DeVito and all of them and how they are now. And we did a little person popped in, shall I say. I don't want to mention any names, Pam Ferris. So, like, we reunited Matilda and Miss Trunchbull. Aww. It was amazing. So that's coming up in a couple of weeks. And
fantastic.
Then we had the Cher Lloyd one as well, which was so interesting from X Factor, just hearing her experience as a 16-year-old being on that show and sort of how the press treated her. And, I mean, it's just crazy.
It's fascinating. It's fascinating.
Yeah.
And you get a long time to talk to people, which is lovely.
It's lovely.
It's
so nice.
Just gorgeous. Now, look, are you all right?
Because
as we know, you know, you've been through a breakup. It's tough anyway, Rylan.
Yeah.
But obviously, when you're in the public eye, it's more difficult. But you're getting there.
I am. I wasn't good. I'm not going to lie. I think everyone knows that. You know, I'm normally on telly every 5 minutes. I apologise. You have to see my mug all the time. But no, I had 4 months off and it was needed, actually. You know, it's been 10 years now I've been doing this job nearly.
You're a grafter.
Which is crazy. So, maybe the time off is exactly what I needed. But I'm good.
I'm really glad you are.
I'm obviously going for a midlife, trying to dye my hair blonde, new teeth. So,
I'm liking the hair. Can I say, I don't really see that much difference in the teeth, do
they're
you?
A lot smaller, Lorraine. They're a lot smaller. Yeah. I mean,
still dazzling, though. And
oh,
perfect.
They're still there. They're still there. Yeah. They're definitely still there. We're halfway through the blonde. I was hosting the hairdressing awards last night.
Right.
So imagine walking up to the hairdressing awards going, hi everyone, 1,000 hairdressers, I'm still lifting the black out, don't judge me. So we're getting there.
Oh no, it's great. And you're working so hard, and obviously you do Strictly,
which I love.
It Takes Two. That is such a great show because we get to find out so much behind the scenes,
and they're so good this year as well.
Oh, like, the standards
are unreal this year.
The standard is crazy.
And, you know, we say it every year, like, oh, we don't know who's going to win, and half the time you're like, actually we do.
Yeah.
Genuinely, this year we don't.
No, we don't.
Because one minute someone's at the top of that leaderboard, the next are at the bottom.
Because you saw on Saturday, John and Johannes were
unbelievable. Unreal.
That was the sexiest thing I think I've ever seen.
Honestly, and we were talking. I was talking to them last night on the show.
It's Bob Fosse, yes.
And the mirror image with these two is
incredible.
Just unbelievable. But that is a massive testament to JoJo as well.
Oh, yeah.
Because he's such a great choreographer, and I'm so thrilled for JoJo because I feel like JoJo now can literally be who he wants to be on the show with John.
The trust between the two
unreal.
Of them is incredible.
They're lifting each other, they're leading each other, and that's so hard to switch a lead mid-dance.
Unbelievable.
It's unreal.
And then we get Rose, who's just...
Rose, I just adore.
Incredible. I mean,
and she has brought the best out in Gio as well.
I think
them
so.
Them two
yes.
together, just the way he is with her and the way she is with him, it's just stunning to watch
it's
backstage because, you know, Rose always has an interpreter with her wherever she goes.
Sure,
and
of course.
Me and Jeanette were learning sign language at the beginning of the series.
I love
so when
that.
We,
so
yeah,
many
so when
are
we when
great,
we interview Rose and Jeanette, Rose will always look at her interpreter, obviously. But with Gio, she's just got that sort of symmetry now with him, where she ignores the interpreter because she knows what Gio's saying. And she doesn't lip read that much, Rose, but with Gio, she just gets
the connection.
They've got such a great, chemistry.
It's been such a great show. It really has.
I think we've needed it as well.
Very special. I love listening to you when I'm pottering at the weekend on your Radio 2 show. You know, when I'm tidying my liquor drawer or doing a bit of weeding or whatever. It's great fun. It's like we're just having a conversation.
I know.
That's the great thing about radio, isn't it?
I mean, I was 30 when I joined Radio 2, and when I got the call, I was like, you sure I'm still not Radio 1? Like, I'm not that old. What are you going on about? But I like to call it Radio 1.5.
Exactly. Radio 1.5.
We do. So, yeah, I'd sort of play a bit of Spice Girls and all my dance music and then chat rubbish with my mum for about 10 minutes. But people seem to like it.
No, of course they do. Of course. I think you were right to take a little bit of time out. It's like you've come back and you're back to yourself.
I am. I'm getting there.
Which is really good.
Just trying to look after myself.
No, exactly. Because people, you know, there's huge affection for you and people were genuinely worried and it's just great to see you back, you know.
I felt
back
a bit like Where's Wally for a while, but sorry for scaring people.
No, you're fine, you're fine. Now, look, what if you had to choose between Big Brother coming back or X Factor coming back?
Now, that is one
of the toughest questions you've ever been asked.
I mean, look, I came from X Factor.
I know you did.
But Big Brother's my child. So I would go for Big Brother. But actually, Lorraine, look, do you know, this is so lovely, you asking me all these questions and that. But it is quite a special day, isn't it? For you, because it's your birthday.
Yes.
St Andrew's Day, you're so Scottish, it's unreal.
Yes.
Literally the epitome of Scotland. Bear with me one second, so I bought you a little present, actually, Lorraine.
Yeah. I love presents.
I'm just going to scooch around here past these beautiful vases and I'm just going to grab this one here. This one here. And I've also got another present for you as well. Let's go through. I think you know who this is. Nice little balloon as well,
Ruby.
And over in the kitchen, we've got you a cake.
Thank you.
What more do you want? Dogs, balloons, and cakes on your birthday. It's a Rylan's birthday, everyone.
Thank you. Oh, Ruby, my wee darling. Oh, you're so cute. Oh, she's gorgeous.
She
is Rosie's little puppy.
But today we lie and say she's yours.
Oh, Ruby, and she's done a wee happy wee.
Oh, how nice.
Oh, thank you,
so
Ruby.
Have I.
And so have I. We're all playing together. Oh, thank you for bringing me my baby because I do miss her so much. I know. Oh, gosh. Rylan's podcast, I should say to you. Reunion is out now. Ruby, I know it's exciting. I know it's very exciting. Oh, hello. Don't forget, you can watch full episodes of Lorraine on the ITV Hub and all the best clips, compilations and playlists right here on our channel. Just subscribe now and you'll never miss an upload. Click here to watch another video similar to this one or click here to head to our channel's homepage to explore all of our exciting videos.